But in back, a lot of these consumer stocks, they're moving higher as we speak. From the mid-cap end of things, we have Nestle, which has moved to the high point of the day. Remember, all of last month, the FMCG stocks did underperform. So Nestle is the one that should come up for you at the high point of the day. Along with that, we have Dabur and Berger Paints too. All the FMCG stocks, they're moving higher, and they're not the non-index, non-FMCG index stocks, which is why the Nifty FMCG is at the lower end of today's trading range. But we have a lot of stocks beneath the surface which have moved higher after last month's underperformance. The stock on our radar, though, is Ratnamani Metals and Tubes. Prakash M. Sanghvi, the CMD of the company, joins us on the show. Thanks a lot, Mr. Sanghvi, for joining us. Before we get cracking on the individual verticals of your business, if you could give us a broader outlook on what exactly is the total order book of the company right now?
As on date, order book roughly about 1400 crore.
Okay, 1400 crores. So, how long is this executable over, sir?
Over 6 to 8 months.
All right, Mr. Sanghvi, let's break up your order book then. How much of it is dependent on the oil and gas space?
Say about 30 to 40%. And oil and gas means refinery, petrochemical, cross-country pipeline. Yeah, that combined with the refinery, petrochemical, cross-country pipeline, gas distribution, city gas distribution pipeline, all put together.
All right, so 30 to 40% of your order book coming in from the oil and gas space. Now, how much is your domestic order book? How much of it is export? And is there a margin differential between the two?
See, margin is more or less same, but in export, say about 20 to 25% of the turnover. It depends on project to project, on year to year, but roughly it is 18 to 25%.
Well, the crucial part in terms of your numbers and in terms of margins going ahead is going to be the breakup of your carbon steel pipes and your stainless steel pipes. So give us that breakup. What's the mix of your order books if I look at CS pipes as well as SS pipes?
Because we have a good capacity in carbon steel in all four type of welded pipes, say LSAW, helical saw, circumferential saw, and ERW. So the order booking more or less on carbon steel side is more, say about 900 crore order, and 400 crore, 400 to 450 crore in stainless steel.
All right, so the high margin business stainless steel has 400 to 450 crores of your order book. The others is carbon steel, which is about 900 crores. Point taken, sir. What capex are you planning and which segment is this going to be in?
We don't have a full range of stainless steel seamless pipe, so we are putting a new capex about say 325 crore, and that will be come in trial production by say October, November, and then things will improve in stainless steel area also.
If you could tell us what's the asset turnover in this particular business, what kind of revenues can you generate, and how are you funding this particular capex?
Mostly it is 2.5 to 3 time.
So does that mean around what, 700, 750 crore revenue from this plant?
Yes. Over the period, starting first year will not be that, because a lot of approvals we need, because any new capacity, new plant, you need further approval of the all these EPCs and consultant.
All right, so 700 to 750 crores is the revenue that you can generate from this plant. We didn't get how you will fund this. Will you be taking more debt for the same? Do you have debt on your books right now?
See, today company is totally debt free, but because the company is doing about, say, in a year, next year and a half, say about 600 crore. So it is partly funded by the long-term term loan. Say about 300 crore, and by 300 crore from internal accruals.
Okay, you just mentioned you're debt free, so if you can elaborate upon why the finance expense on your income statement, and I think they're higher on a year-on-year basis, they're closer to doubled.
So that is mostly LC and bank guarantee charges, because a lot of bank guarantee we have to issue for performance of the product. And LCs for import of the raw material.
Okay, so those are LCs and bank guarantee charges. You've been talking about CapEx and the potential for it to grow to around, you know, 700 to 750 crores in terms of revenue. With all this in place, by FY20, what sort of revenue can you do?
See, FY20, you can say 1920 might not that, but you can say 2021, it definitely touch of, say, 3,600 to 4,000 crore.
3,600 to 4,000 crores. That looks like a good number. But final question, what about margins for FY21?
Say at EBITDA level, say 16% to 17% range, you can say.
Okay, all right. Thanks so much for joining in and giving us all those details, Mr. Sanghvi. Well, we'll have to wait by. It's going to be quite interesting, Mangalam, because their stainless steel pipes, as a percentage of the total revenues, that had fallen in the past quarter. And stainless steel pipes, they're the higher margin business.
Right.
So because the stainless steel pipes in terms of the revenue mix had fallen down, that's why in the last quarter, that's in quarter three, we had seen that the margins had come in at the lowest we've seen in the last few quarters. So interesting to see. We'll have to track the stainless steel pipes more than the other business. And as he told us, as of now, it's around 400 crores is the outstanding order book. So we'll wait by to
and
see.
There is new capex coming in this vertical as well. So which is why perhaps he says that, you know, the margins can
improve.
Yep. All right. So we'll definitely watch out for that. We'll sit for a short break, come back, and we get in some important opinion coming in.